Right, it's a laugh a minute. It's about capital punishment in apartheid. It's great. you know, it's an interesting film because it's from the perspective of it's kind of difficult to get on the same page as the young boy who really is the lead of the film. He's the center of the film. Because he's committed this atrocious crime, and it's and he's committed it because he's come to a breaking point. and it felt like an unusual and valid story to tell, and kind of, you know, it's felt at odds. Telling it felt, I think, at odds telling it with ourselves, you know. It was a very strange process making it. It was very, very difficult to make emotionally. And it was also, you know, really, really wonderful. I've made a lot of work in South Africa, and that's why we made it in Cape Town. And it's just so beautiful there. That's kind of a homecoming in itself, in the sense that we all sort of travelled from there long ago, except that I got really, really, really pale. I went on a super long journey. Yeah. Gary N, who plays the young boy, he's just such a treasure. He's so lovely and a friend, and, you know, we made friends on the film. Yeah, he just wanted to give it everything, and it was a really difficult role to play. He just spent the whole time in tears. I know what that's like. I've done a few parts where I just cried all the way through, and it's harrowing. And he was just very courageous, and he's very special. Through understanding our past, we have the chance to live better in the present. And you know, thank goodness for people like Howard Zinn, who look back on American history and accounted it in the most unbiased way. He's a great hero of mine, and there are lots of brilliant South African writers who've done the same. There's a lot of great material to look at. When we were researching it, there was a lot of great material. It's important to tell it because it happened, and important to tell it in the least biased way possible. It's a film, so at the same time, it has this romantic, swelling narrative where you need to be on the side of at least one of the protagonists. You need to be with someone. You need to travel through someone in the film, and there are really three characters you can hang on to in this film: prosecution, defense, and this boy who's on trial. So, none of them are perfect options. I don't think commercial blockbuster fare can tackle much, really. I can't see how it would help anything politically. They gave Michael Bay Benghazi, which I thought was sorry and shameful. But yes, I think a smaller festival is a perfect platform for a film like this. And I also think it's so important not to be, you know, the really important thing is that while all of this was going on, there were brilliant people who had positive attitudes and who got through life, you know, and I think it's really important to focus on that rather than kind of like get overly kind of into the upper middle class side of just bemoaning everyone's plight, but looking at the film and thinking, wow, people survived this, you know, and we have broke free of the chains of apartheid, which is phenomenal. So it's important to be joyful about it, you know. One of the really beautiful things about going to Cape Town is seeing everything that Mandela did, and everything that his spirit inspired. And all of the people who worked on the crew had worked on the Mandela film before that, and they felt so, in their words, blessed to have been part of a film that it was very important to them to be part of that Idris Elba Mandela film, you know. So it's important to focus on the joy too. I would really like to see a lot more, you know, I'd love to see a comedy about poor people, you know, like that's not like just a regular, you know, that's not a tragedy. It's either got to be like a ridiculous comedy or a tragedy if you know, people aren't hugely affluent, which is so boring. I just think diversity is interesting and more accurately reflects life, you know.